Assalamualaikum dear students, how are you? Hope you are fine by the grace of Almighty Allah. This is Sabrina Jahan Bhuiya, assistant teacher of English, National Ideal English Version School, Morning Shift. Dear students, today I am going to take English language class for the students of class 4. Look here, dear students, our topic is tense, present and past tense we are going to discuss. And this is our lecture number 13 and SW number 11. Okay, dear students, now I am going to discuss about our today's topic. Look, dear students, here we are going to discuss about tense. At first, you have to know what is tense. Dear students, before starting our class, at first I am going to say some examples in front of you. Look here. Read the sentences in the following dialogue. Teacher said, "Where are you today?" Then the student said, "What? I am in Dhaka today." Then again, teacher said, "Where are you yesterday?" Then the student said, "I was in Khulna." Look here again. Teacher said, where will you be tomorrow? Where will you be tomorrow? Then the student said, "I will be in Rajshahi tomorrow." Now, dear students, please follow this carefully. In these questions and answers, we have been talking about three different types. Okay, look here. Dear students, in these questions we have talking about three different times. The first question and its answer are about the present time. Look here, where are you today? And the student said what? I am in Dhaka today. Okay, so dear students, here what we have found? We have found that the first question and its answer are about the present time today. And look here, in the second question, in the second pair, look, where are you yesterday? And the student said, "I was in Khulna." Look, dear students, in the second prayer, the second prayer are about past time, yesterday. Okay, look, in this third sentence, where will you be tomorrow? And the student said, "What? I will be in Rajshahi tomorrow." Look, dear students, here the third are about future time, that means tomorrow. So, dear students, here as we have seen that in the above sentences the verbs have different forms which indicate different times, okay? And these different forms are called tenses. Is it clear now? Look, dear students, in the above sentences the verbs have different forms which indicate different times, and these different forms are called what? Tenses, okay? So now we'll see its definition. Look, the time of accomplishing any action of a verb is called tense. Okay, I am repeating. The time of accomplishing any action of a verb is called what? Tense. Now look, dear students, there are three principal tenses. What are they? Present tense, past tense and future tense. Okay, what are they? Present tense, past tense and future tense. Now I am going to say about present tense its definition. Look, what is present tense? The present tense describes an action in the present time. Okay, the present tense describes an action in the present time. For example, she sings a song. Okay, or the boy is playing football. So here what we have found from present tense? This tense describes an action in the present time. Now we'll discuss about past tense. What is past tense? The past tense describes an action in the past time. Okay, the past tense describes an action in the past time. For example, she sang a song, the boy was playing football, like this way. Dear students, here we will discuss only present and past tense, okay, and their classification too. Okay, look, now I am going to discuss about their forms. Look here, each of these principal tenses has four forms. Each of these principal tenses has four forms. Dear students, if you want to know about future tense, then I'm going to say that the future tense describes an action in the future time. Okay, the future tense describes an action in the future time. Like for example, she'll sing a song, the boy will be playing football. Okay, but in our today's lecture we are going to discuss only present and past tense. Okay, look, each of these principal tenses has four forms. What are they? They are indefinite or simple, then continuous, then number C perfect, then number D, perfect continuous tense. So what we have found, number A indefinite or simple, then number B continuous, then number C perfect, and number D perfect continuous tense. So what we have found? We have found that each of these principal tenses has four forms. That means present tense has four forms, like that past tense also has four forms. Okay. And like this way, future tense also has four forms. Okay. And here you can find the chart. Acha, now dear students, now we are going to discuss about present tense. Okay. Look, present tense has four forms. What are they? We have already learned this. Look, simple present tense, present continuous tense, present perfect tense, and present perfect continuous tense. Okay, in this chart you will see this. What are they? Present tense has four forms, and what are they? Simple present tense, present continuous tense, present perfect, and present perfect continuous tense. Now I am going to discuss about simple present tense. What is simple present tense? The simple present tense describes an action in the present time. It also describes habitual actions and universal truths. Okay. Look dear students, here verb is used after the subject. If the subject is in the third person singular number, s or es is added to the verb. Okay. If the subject is in the third person singular number, s or es is added to the verb. If the verb ends in ss, hs, sh, ch, x or o, es is added to it. If the verb ends in y preceded by consonant, y is changed to ies. In all other cases, s is added. Okay. For example, the boy in bracket play football. What is his answer? The boy plays football. Because what we have learned? We have learned that if the subject is in the third person singular number, s or es is added to the verb. Okay. So here we have to add s after the verb. The boy plays football. Then look here another example. He always in bracket carry an umbrella with him. And his answer is what? He always carries an umbrella with him. Look dear students, if I going to say structure, the structure is what? Subject plus present form of principal verb and plus object plus extension. Example, he reads a book. He reads a book. Look dear students, here read is a verb and we have written its present form. Okay. Look, he reads a book. Look here, he is subject and reads is what? Reads means present form of principal verb, and a book is used here as an object. Okay, as object. Then look the present continuous tense. The present continuous tense describes an action which is going on at present. The present continuous tense describes an action which is going on at present. For structure, subject plus be verb like am, is, are, in agreement with number and person, plus base form of the main verb along with ing plus extension. For example, Rifat is reading a book. Look dear students, here am is used with I, and is is used with he, she, it, and with all other third person singular numbers, and are is used after we, you, they, and with all plural subjects. Okay. Now I am going to say about present perfect tense. The tense describing an action which has just finished but the result of which still continues is called the present perfect tense. Structure, subject plus have or has plus past participle of the main verb plus extension if any. For example, I have eaten rice, or he has gone to school. Look dear students, here has is used with he, she, it, and with all other third person singular numbers, and have is used with I, we, you, they, and with other plural objects. Okay. Now I am going to say about present perfect continuous tense. The present perfect continuous tense expresses that the action has been going on for some time and is not finished yet. So what we have learned from this definition? The present perfect continuous tense expresses that the action has been going on for some time and is not finished yet. If I going to say its structure, you will find it easily. Okay. Look, structure, subject plus have been or has been plus base form of the verb along with ing plus extension. I am going to say its example. They have been playing football for 2 hours. They have been playing football for 2 hours. Another example I am going to say. I have been reading since morning. I have been reading since morning. Okay, dear students, now we will see about past tense. Okay, look dear students, here about past tense, here you will find that past tense has four forms. Okay, you will find that past tense has four forms. What are they? They are simple past tense, past continuous tense, past perfect tense and past perfect continuous tense. What are they? I am repeating: simple past tense, past continuous tense, past perfect tense and past perfect continuous tense. And dear students, what we have learned from past tense? We have learned that past tense means what? The past tense describes an action in the past time. Okay dear students, now dear students, look here, we will learn about its we have already learned about its four forms, and now we'll discuss about the simple past tense. Okay, what is simple past tense? Dear students, simple past tense means the past simple tense denotes an action that took place in the past and the result of which is no longer present. Okay, I'm going to say structure: subject plus past form of the principal verb plus extension. I'm repeating: subject plus past form of principal verb plus extension. Okay, for example, I went to school. So what we have learned from this definition, from this structure, we have learned that the past simple tense denotes an action that took place in the past and the result of which is no longer present. Okay, now dear students, I am going to discuss about past continuous tense. Look here, the structure is subject plus was or were plus principal verb along with ing plus extension, and the example is I was reading a book. Okay, the example is what? I was reading a book. So dear students, look here, about this definition, we can say about the past continuous tense is what? The past continuous tense denotes that an action was going on in the past for some time. Okay, the past continuous tense denotes that an action was going on, in the past for some time. Okay, now dear students, I am going to say structure: subject plus was or were plus principal verb along with ing plus extension. I have already said that. And what is about this example? I was reading a book, or I was playing football. Okay, now look dear students, now we'll discuss about the past perfect tense. What is past perfect tense? About its definition, dear students, the past perfect tense is used for an activity completed before a certain time in the past to refer to two activities, one of which happened earlier, as a past form of the present perfect tense. Okay, if I going to say structure, structure is what? Subject plus had plus past participle of the principal verb plus extension. Look here, the example is what? I had reached the college before the examination began. I had reached the college before the examination began. Okay dear students, now I am going to discuss about the past perfect continuous tense. Look dear students, about the past perfect continuous tense, about its definition, you can say the past perfect continuous is the past form of the present perfect continuous. It is used to refer to an action in the past which had been continuing before something else happened. I am going to say structure: subject plus had been plus verb along with ing plus extension. Look dear students, if I going to say an example, you will find it easily, you can get this easily. Look, for example, I had been reading for 2 hours. I am repeating: I had been reading for 2 hours. Okay dear students, so like this way you have to learn all of this structure properly at your home. Now dear students, I am going to discuss about this exercise. Look dear students, here you have to transform this into different kinds of tenses. Look here, the first exercise number 1. Dear students, I am going to write this on the board. Here you have to write exercise. Okay, exercise. Look, number 1, I have been reading for 2 hours. You have to turn it, you have to transform this sentence into past perfect continuous tense. Look here, what is the, so the sentence is what? I had been reading for 2 hours. had been reading for 2 hours. Okay, dear students, as per our structure of past perfect continuous tense, what we have learned from that structure? We have learned that subject plus had been plus verb along with ing plus object. Okay, then we have to write it like this way: I had been reading for 2 hours. Then look number 2, the boy plays football. We have to transform this sentence into past indefinite tense. So as per our structure of past indefinite tense, we have to write this like this way: the boy played football. Okay, the boy played football. That means the boy is subject here, then past form of verb, past form of the main verb, and then object. Okay, look, the boy played football. Then number 3, people are waiting. We have to transform this into present continuous tense, and the sentence is what? People are waiting. Then number 4, he lived alone. Here, this sentence you have to transform into past perfect tense. Look here, he had lived alone. Then number 5, they are honest. It's past indefinite. You have to transform this sentence into past indefinite form. What is that? They are honest. Then number 6, the boy helps his father. You have to transform this sentence into past continuous tense. So if we follow past continuous tense structure, then we have to transform, we have to write this sentence like this way: the boy was helping his father. Because we have learned from past continuous tense structure, we have learned that subject plus was or were plus verb along with ing plus object. Okay, we have learned this from the structure of past continuous tense. For this reason, we have to transform this sentence, we have to write this sentence like this way: the boy was helping his father. Then number 7, I went to school. We have to transform this sentence into present indefinite tense. Look, I go to school. Then number 8, I have done the work. We have to transform this sentence into past perfect tense: I have done the work. Then number 9, you wait here for 2 hours. We have to transform this sentence into present perfect continuous tense. Look here, the sentence is what? You have been waiting for here for 2 hours. Then number 10, they visit this place. We have to transform this sentence into present perfect tense. So the sentence is what? They have visited this place. They have visited this place. If you follow the structure of present perfect tense, then you have to write this sentence like this way: they have visited this place. Okay, dear students. So dear students, that's all about our today's topic. We have to learn this topic properly, and your SW will be, your SW is exercise 1 to 5. These 5 exercises you have to do as your homework, and you have to submit this on next Saturday. So dear students, I hope you have understood our today's topics. See you again in the next class. Allah Hafiz.